okay, just, you're gonna have to log out. You need to go to class. You can walk back with Cheryl. I think you guys, are you going to PE right now? You need to get going. I don't know where they're gonna be going. All right, see you later. Bye. Okay, so I was just talking to this gardener earlier, and every year we have fifth graders research a saint, and you are going to create a keynote presentation on your saint. And this is the same saint that you're going to dress up as for All Saints Day. And it's something we do every year with fifth grade. It's a lot of fun. So we are going to start getting ready for that. You're also going to be working in your religion class to get ready for that. You're going to pick a saint, and Mrs. Gardner has to approve it. She's going to show you some different ways she wants you to research it. And then we will start making it in here in a couple of weeks. But for now, we are going to, today we're going to watch a brain pop on plagiarism, because it's something that always comes up when we're creating these slideshows, because you will be going online and finding facts about your saints as well as using books, and it's important that you realize that you can't just copy word for word. You have to put it into your own words, and you have to also put anything, direct quotes, in quotation marks, and attribute it to the person who said it. So if you copy something exactly from a book, you have to say who said it. You can't pretend that it was your own words. Because that's cheap. And remember last week in the acceptable use policy, I read you that about plagiarism, and that it's considered cheating. So to start with today, we're going to watch a brain pop video about plagiarism to just explain it a little bit. And plagiarism is a little complicated. It confuses kids a little bit. It's an issue that we always have to deal with. We always have a couple of kids every school year who get in trouble with plagiarism. They're usually middle schoolers. Fifth graders, we know that you're just starting to learn. But the older you get, the more we expect that you know and that you understand what is expected of you as far as plagiarism, okay? So, let's get started. Watch this video and then we'll talk about it in a little bit.
We're back with best-selling author and tropical sociopath, Moby Calrissian. Your recent book report on The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe was largely stolen from online sources. Is there anything you'd like to say to the American public?
Something off your chest. Dear Tim and Moby, I know plagiarism is cheating, but sometimes it's hard to tell if I'm actually breaking the rules. Can you help me out? From Moira. Of course we can, Moira. Plagiarism is the act of submitting someone else's work as your own. You're never allowed to use the words or ideas of other people without giving them credit. This rule applies to all subjects and classes. It doesn't matter if you're doing a science project, a book report, or even making a piece of art. Well, some instances of plagiarism are pretty obvious. Say you have to write a paper on The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe by C.S. Lewis. You go online and find a great resource with lots of cool ideas about the book. If you copy some of the text from the site and paste it into your own paper, then hand it in just like that, well, that's a pretty clear violation. Yep, stealing from any type of source and claiming it as your own work is always plagiarism. That source could be a book, an article, an old paper your sister wrote, anything. When teachers give you assignments, they don't want you to just repeat and recap existing material or stuff you find online. They're trying to assess your understanding of the topics you're studying and see how well you can put your own original thoughts into writing. Plagiarizing someone else is like cheating off them on a test. Get caught and you'll probably get a zero on that assignment. Or, if you're lucky, your teacher might let you rewrite it. In high school or college, punishments for plagiarism can be even more severe. You might fail the entire class or get kicked out of school completely. It's not that you can't use magazines, books, encyclopedias, or their online versions. In fact, it's a good idea to consult all of those sources when doing papers and projects. But if you use someone else's words verbatim, meaning the exact same words, you need to put them in quotation marks. And you have to attribute or give credit to the author. One of the easiest ways to do this is to use phrases like according to, and then add the name of your source right after. Depending on the subject, teacher, or type of assignment, you might need to use footnotes or endnotes too. Those are more formal ways to credit your sources. Footnotes show sources at the bottom of the page, and endnotes list them after a specific section or at the conclusion of your report. Sometimes, you might also be required to put together a bibliography. That's a comprehensive list of all the works you consulted while researching an assignment. I was just getting to that. Many examples of plagiarism aren't obvious cut and paste jobs. Unfortunately, a lot of students wind up plagiarizing by accident. If you're not careful, key ideas from a source can easily slip into your writing. Like here, the original sentence was, more than a scene-setting element, snow comes to symbolize death itself. And you wrote, Lewis uses the symbol of snow to represent death. You did a good job of paraphrasing the material, putting it into your own words. But the thing is, you're still using the same basic idea, that Lewis uses snow to symbolize death. It can be tricky untangling your own ideas from your sources, so when in doubt, give credit. There are a few other important tips to guard against plagiarism. When taking notes, put big quotation marks around all direct quotes, even if it's only a few words. And write the source next to every note you take, whether it's a website, book, or article. These are pretty straightforward strategies that can help you avoid getting into any trouble. What? No way! I totally did not lift that from your, blog. Huh. Must have gotten stuck in my head from when I first read it. It was so not on purpose.
Alright, so let's go ahead and take the quiz. This quiz is a little hard. We did it in the last class, but we'll do them together, okay? So, on its own, which of the following is most likely an example of plagiarism? Okay? So, consulting an online resource when you write a research paper. Well, that's something you should do. You should consult, so that's not plagiarism. Pulling a quote from a magazine article in an essay. Well, you can pull a quote. You can put a quote from a magazine article, but you just have to say who said it, right? Forgetting to put quotation marks around a quote, does that sound like it? No, you don't think so? Paraphrasing the author of a published book. Well, that's okay if you're paraphrasing. I think it's C.
Yeah.
Because you can't forget to put quotation marks around a quote, right? That's important. So if you were quoting Martin Luther King, I had a dream, you have to put quotation marks saying that he said it. Let's do that. Okay. Why is plagiarism similar to fraud? Does anyone know what fraud is? Yes. Mess up, yeah.
Well, that's because
if you're fraud. Yes, so if you're fraud, what do they think you are? Yes.
Fake.
Fake, that's perfect. Fake, yeah. If you're a fake or a cheat, you're a fraud. So why is plagiarism similar to fraud? Because you're not paying to use a source's ideas, because you're passing off a source's ideas or words as your own, because you're making money off of the source's ideas, or because plagiarism wastes your teacher's valuable time. Max.
B.
Very good. B. Excellent. All right. In school, what is the punishment for plagiarism? You receive an F, receiving failing grade in the class, you get expelled from the school, or it depends on the teacher in the school. Yes. What is it? Correct. It depends on the teacher in the school, and it also depends on what grade you're in. So like I said earlier, we would be a lot easier on a fifth grader who plagiarized versus an eighth grader, because we expect eighth graders, they've been learning this for a lot more years. They have been in school a lot longer, so they should know more than you guys do, right? So that also depends on how old you are. Okay. Which of the following is a verbatim? Remember he used that word? Repetition of the sentence. The cat jumped over the lazy brown fox. Does anyone remember what he said verbatim was? Verbatim means word for word. So Ella, what's the answer? Mm-hmm. What is it? D? No, it's words.
Or B?
Oh, B. No, word for word, Lola.
C.
Good. So verbatim means word for word. So it's exactly what that says. Word for word. Okay. How are endnotes different from footnotes? This one's hard. Endnotes, I'll just tell you guys, they list the sources in a different place. Do you remember in the video how they put the number at the end of some information, and then you go down to the bottom of the page and it lists the sources? That's what an endnote is, okay? That's a little hard. All right, to find out whether a specific source was used in a research paper, the reader should consult the, this is an easy one, you guys should know this. Yes, Justin? Very good, bibliography. That lists the sources you use. All right, how does attribution for online sources compare to attribution for offline sources? So this is a tricky one. Attribution is where you say who said it, whose idea it is. You're attributing it to them. So anyone have any guesses? Max?
A.
I think that's a good one. Yep, good job, Max. All right, that was a hard one. What can you conclude from the fact that people often plagiarize without meaning to? It's not a serious offense. The rules aren't strict. Most teachers aren't aware of plagiarism, or it's not always obvious. Let's see. Yes, Nathan? Yeah, you are right. It's not always obvious. It can be hard. And that's a good example of if you are in doubt, especially if you're in my class or one of your teacher's class downstairs, ask them. Ask your teachers, especially at your age. We don't expect that you know everything about plagiarism. You're just learning. So ask, and we'll always help you out. Okay. Why is paraphrasing not a guaranteed way to avoid plagiarism? This is a hard one. We had a hard time with this one last class. It often changes the original idea. Even restated ideas need to be properly attributed. Some ideas are not easily paraphrased. Paraphrase sentences are identical to the originals. What is it? Yes, Sarah?
B.
Very good. Very good. Even, they still need to be attributed. Even if you paraphrase it, restate it, you still need to say whose idea it was. Plagiarizing is like cheating because you'll get kicked out of school, you'll get caught and get a failing grade, it's a synonym for cheating, or you'll lose the chance to practice your writing skills. Yes?
D?
I really think this one should be all of the above. What do you guys think?
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's D. D is the answer, but I really think all of them could apply. But D is the correct one. All right, good job, guys. That was a super hard quiz. All right, so we will talk more about this as we start our Saints project in a couple of weeks. But for now, we will close it. All right, so now we are going to get started. started on Tech to Learn for the school year. Okay? So you guys can all open up. And we don't have any new students in here, right? So you, oh, we do have one new student. Yes. Okay, so you should definitely listen to this. And if you guys forgot how to get into Tech to Learn, you can pay attention to this too. So Tech to Learn is in your ACS folder, the top folder. Double click on Type to Learn. Okay. So, when you get into here, everyone has the same account code, 130099. It's always on the board. You don't have to memorize this. I'll always have it on the board up there. All right, then your username, you are all 24. Everyone starts with 24. That's the year you graduate. And then you put the first letter of your first name. No capitals at all. So, the first letter of your first name, I'm going to log in as Elise Henson. So, E for Elise, you put in the first letter of your name, and then your whole last name. And then the password is that same thing, but without the 24. So, E Henson. Oh, there we go. Did you get in? What's that? So, here's how you get in. You click Launch Type to Learn. And it's going to load. All of you are beginning on lesson 6 this school year, so you got to skip the first 5 lessons. Because you've already had enough practice with those. So, just to remind you, we all need to do the lesson first, the begin part. So, it will not let you click on any of the games unless you do the lesson to begin with. Once you finish this lesson, it's going to give you a green check mark. And then you can go ahead and do the games in whatever order you want. And then the final challenge lasts. Drone Control doesn't have a check mark because it's optional. Sometimes it can be hard to pass, so that's why I make it optional. But give it a try because it's really good for your speed work. We do not do Message Master, that's why there's an X. So I just want to show you guys something when you go into the begin section. Here's, do you see the hands here? This is showing you how to place your hands on the keyboard. So I want you to try to keep your hands like theirs are on the home row. It might feel weird at first, but the more you practice like that, the easier it'll get to stay into the habit of keeping your fingers around this area. Okay? This is steps, so 1 through 6. That kind of keeps you track. This lesson, the beginning can feel really long, so I think it helps to keep track of the steps so it shows you where you are. Always remember, if you look on the left-hand side, it says your current goals. You have 10 words per minute and 80% accuracy. So sometimes I have kids who just, they're not really trying, and maybe they're goofing around and just hitting a bunch of random letters. And then they finish the lesson and they don't get the green check mark. That's because they didn't pass. They didn't make that accuracy goal. Now you can miss some. You can miss 20%. That's a lot, actually. So you can miss some, so you don't need to stress out. As long as you're doing your best, you'll pass. But please keep in mind, you can't just play around and hit a bunch of goofy letters. And also,